اكبر لا اله الا الله لا صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم اجعل قلب بان ويشيك وامصار ورزق دارا وأولاد يبدال وجعل لا عند كبد نبيك محمد مصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم مستقر وقرارا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، نعم المولى ونعم النصير. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على حبيب إله العالمين، حافظ سره ومبلغ رسالاته، الرسول المسدد، المصطفى الأمجد، المحمود الأحمد، أبي القاسم محمد. وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين، ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. أما بعد، سلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. In Surah Bani Israel, which is the 17th chapter of Quran Majid, verse number 9, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ, which means that indeed this Quran guides to what is most upright. Quran itself is guidance. In our lives, one of the most important thing is Quran Majid. And if a person does not believe in Quran Majid, then he's kafir. It is extremely important that we need to have that relation with this divine book, with this holy book. And sometimes, I'm not telling you, but I'm talking to myself also at times, when we make our own research, we think that we have made injustice to this book, to this divine book. That relation which we need to build with Quran and Majid, we have not built that relation. On the contrary, we have forsaken and neglected this divine book. Now, it is something which is extremely important. First of all, let us think and reflect what does Quran mean when I speak of Quran, when I talk of Quran, or if any of my sentence, if I bring the word Quran, what kind of entity comes in my mind when I think of Quran? We have been using this holy book in different occasions, in happy moments, in sad occasions. We have been using time and again. Yeah, it's just for the usage, isn't it? We hold it, yeah, in the happy occasions, in sad occasions, many a times. Yeah, in important occasions, we take Quran, isn't it? In different things. But have we tried to reflect and think? Have we implemented upon Quran? What does the word Quran mean to us? What does it mean? Quran comes from the word qara'a. And the first verse which was revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Holy Prophet was Iqra. And Iqra again it comes from Qara'a, which means read. Quran means read. Now, how important it is, and when does it become beneficial to me? How beneficial it is to me? And how important and how beneficial does it become to me spiritually, in spiritual grounds? Just to see Quran is thawab, it is rewarding. To recite Quran is rewarding. Our Imams have said, Imam Rizai said, that I would have recited more and more. But no, there is no time. I want to even do research on Quran Majid. The servant of Ahlul Bayt, known as Fidha, when she stayed with the Holy Lady, she got that art of replying and giving response to people through Quran Majid. Yani whatever she spoke was Quran Majid. She was a ghere masuma. She is not from that list of the 14 infallibles. But how she had built relation with Quran Majid. So how can I build relation with Quran Majid? How does it benefit? When does it benefit me? How does it become beneficial to me? Yes, it is very interesting. If you see the verse of Surah Bani Israel, chapter number 17, verse number 82, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. This is Quran, Surah Bani Israel, chapter 17, verse number 82. Allah says that we have revealed Quran for the believers so that it becomes a healing for them. Shifa. Shifa is healing. Warahma. Yani Quran is a mercy for the believers. For us, for you and I, it becomes a mercy. Then Allah says, وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. But for the zalimeen, for the oppressors, it's nothing but perdition for the unjust ones. Perdition means, it means that entire chastisement, eternal chastisement. It is nothing, but it is punishment for the zalimeen. Simple example is, مَثَلُهُمْ كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَصْفَارَ. Quran says that the similitude of the Jews, of the children of Israel, is like that of donkey. مَثَلُهُمْ كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَصْفَارَ. When you keep books, asfar, on the back of the donkey would not know what has it carried. Whether it has carried valuable books, it has carried Torah or not, no. Allah says in Quran Majid, in Surah Jum'ah, and we have been hearing this time and again, every Friday, in the first rakat, مَثَلُهُمْ كَمَثَلِ, this verse number 5 of Surah Jum'ah, that there's the similitude of the children of Israel is like that of donkeys, because they got Torah, they got Torah, but they did not value it. They did not build relation with the Torah. Thus, they are like donkeys. They are like himar. Can you imagine that if I want Quran should benefit me spiritually, then what are the methods? What are the conditions for Quran to benefit me spiritually? Scholars are saying that there are three conditions. The first condition is that my heart needs to be humble, first of all, completely humble. This is the first condition. Try to remove grudges from the heart. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَوْ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Make your heart قَلْبِ سَلِيمٍ, according to Quran. قَلْبِ سَلِيمٍ means immaculate heart, completely. Remove that grudge. First, make your heart humble. The second condition is, make your mind clear, focused towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third condition is that free from distractions. The environment should be such that there shouldn't be distraction. Then Quran Majid will benefit you spiritually. In the time of Umar, the second caliph, there was a person who would go to Umar's house and he would ask material assistance. Now sometimes, you know, you get into their nerves. You know, people, they hate you. Sometimes there's no reason. They can't stand you. They just see you, I don't like to see him. I just hate him, God forbid. It's bad. It's better that a person has a clear heart, immaculate heart, qalb-e salim, pure heart, and remove all that grudges, because at the end, we will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, Quran says that it will be a day, the day of judgment, that neither wealth nor children will avail. Only the clear heart will help. Umar got tired. He said that, Baba, what did you think? This is the house of Umar. It is not mosque. It is not Baitul Wal. It is not masjid. Go to the house of Allah. and ask assistance there. Once, twice I've given you, but now I'm tired. He was irritated by this beggar coming on and on and on. Now, why don't you go to the mosque, read Quran, Umar is saying, and you might get some lessons and morals from Quran and implement upon it. This person secluded himself from the community. He got disheartened. He went completely, he isolated himself. He went high on the mountains and he stayed there. And after a few months, when Umar thought he remembered him, he said that I have not seen him for quite long. When he asked his whereabouts, he was told that he is at a particular place. Umar went to visit him, the second caliph. When he goes to visit him and he asks him that what happened? Why have you isolated yourself from the community, from the society? So he says that when you told me go to read Quran, I went and I opened Quran. I just pondered on one verse of Quran-e-Majid. That verse of Quran-e-Majid made me independent from Umar and his people. Only one verse of Quran. So Umar was interested to know. He said that which verse of Quran is that? He says this is the verse of Surah Dhariyat, chapter number 51, verse number 22, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُعَدُونَ. Such a beautiful verse of Quran. Only one verse. It changes the life of a person. Allah says in Quran, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ, and your sustenance is in the heavens. وَمَا تُعَدُونَ, what you are promised. Umar said that you are speaking the truth. He said, after this, I thought that why am I looking for material assistance from the people on this earth whilst Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised that my sustenance is in the heavens. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر آمنا بالله وصدق الله العلي العظيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين إنه خير ناصر ومعين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين شفيع المذنبين رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد اللهم أجل فرجهم والصلاة والسلام على علي أمير المؤمنين وصي رسول رب العالمين علي بن أبي طالب والصلاة والسلام على صديقة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء بنت رسول الله سيدة نساء العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سبط الرحمة الحسن والحسين سيدي الشباب أهل الجنة والصلاة والسلام على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والحجة القائمة المنتظر المهدي فرجهم بقية الله خير لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين صلوا على محمد وآل محمد Can you imagine that Quran becomes so important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that night when Quran is revealed, it becomes better than 1,000 months. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. Why? because we have revealed Quran in that night. Inna anzalnahu. That who is Zamir, is a pronoun, which turns back to Quran, which means that we have revealed this, yani Quran, on that night. And because we have revealed Quran, that night becomes better. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. It becomes better than 1,000 months. And 1,000 months is equivalent to 82 years. One night is better than 82 years. And that is why you will find that even in some amals, we are told to recite Surah Qadr. We shall be performing, inshallah, the amal of Laylatul Raghaib this Thursday, coming Thursday. The first Thursday of the holy month of Rajab is called Laylatul Raghaib. And there is a special amal to be done, which we perform every year. It is a 12 rakat salah. Yeah, sets of two rakat, set of six. In every rakat, after Surah Al-Hamd, Surah Qadr is supposed to be recited thrice. And then Surah Ikhlas 12 times. It is supposed to be performed between Namaz Maghrib and Isha. It takes an hour or so. We'll try to be quick so that we finish early. It is said that the benefit of this amal is that on the first night of the grave, in Wahsha, don't we pray Namaz Wahsha? Wahsha means fear. When a deceased is fearful, at that time he will see a handsome person coming in his grave. And he will be asking that, who are you? And he will say that, I'm that amal. I've come in a mujassam. I've come in that shape and form. You have performed on the first night of the holy month of Rajab. On the first Thursday of the holy month of Rajab. On Laylatul Raghaib. So it is extremely rewarding, this amal. And we don't know that will we get the opportunity to perform next year or not. So it's better that when we get this opportunity, grab this opportunity and perform this amal, which is called Amal Laylatul Raghaib. And in that, Surah Qadr is supposed to be recited. Indeed, Quran is abundant, unfortunately. It is forsaken. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Furqan that on the Day of Judgment, the Holy Prophet will scream, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنِّي قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. That the messenger cried out that they have treated this Quran as a forsaken thing. Everything has got a season. Yeah, the scholars say, imma say, balke, this is the hadith of our fifth holy imam. Tonight, we shall be celebrating the birth anniversary of our fifth holy imam. Tonight is the first night of the holy month of Rajab. Yeah, and we shall be starting to recite the dua of Yaman Arjuhu li kulli khair. Inshallah. The first night of the holy month of Rajab. It is also the birth anniversary of the fifth imam. And the fifth holy imam is quoted to have said that everything has a season. The season of Quran is the holy month of Ramadan. Now, we are not entering the holy month of Ramadan, definitely. But Maah Rajab is the preparation of the holy month of Ramadan. The way we prepare ourselves, we start fasting in the holy month of Rajab. It is Rajabul Murajab. It is a sacred month. Then it comes Shabanul Mukarram. It is also sacred. Then it comes Maah Ramadanul Mubarak. That is also sacred. The way we prepare ourselves to fast, we should also prepare ourselves to build relation with Quran Majid. You'll find that we have forsaken and neglected Quran Majid. Rajab comes in our life. It goes. Shaban comes. And then it goes. Maah Ramadan comes. It goes. Every year it comes. We are lucky to witness the Rajab of this month, of this year. Then what have we done? What have we planned? Pondering in Quran Majid, having that relation with Quran Majid is extremely important. Imam Muhammad Baqir says that a mu'min is supposed to recite 50 verses of Quran daily. 50 verses of Quran. And if not 50 verses, then at least one makra, one ruku. In the margin there is ayn in Quran. From one ayn to another ayn. At least that part is supposed to be recited. And on the Day of Judgment, you'll find these three entities will complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is Quran Majid. Quran will complain that they did not even bother to ponder on me, let alone ponder. They did not even see me. They did not even touch me. Only when Maah Ramadan came, they took from the shelf. That also they cleared the dust on top of the cover of Quran. It will complain on the Day of Judgment. Quran Majid, Masajid, mosques will also complain on the Day of Judgment. And Alim, the practicing Alim, will complain on the Day of Judgment. indeed these ulamas, their worth and their value, just to look at an alim, it is rewarding. It is the hadith of the Holy Prophet of Islam, that by looking at the face of a practicing alim, it is thawab. See, because it reminds you his actions. Yeah, in those times after the revolution of Iranian revolution, people would keep the photos of Imam Khomeini rahimahullah alayhi at their homes. Yeah, why? Because we remember these scholars. It is sawab just to look at an alim. Yeah, a jurist, an alim. You can imagine that when Imam Khomeini passed away in 1989, millions of people, they wept so much. They were hitting their chests. Yeah, so many people in the funeral, they were weeping and they said that we have become yatim, we have become orphan. An alim, a practicing alim, is a father of a community. The way you have got a photograph of your father at your home, it is not bad to have a photo anywhere of an alim, even if it at your home. If it is a photograph there, you look at an alim, you remember that alim. You remember his actions. You remember his advice. He is the father of a community. And when a jurist passes away, may Allah protect Ayatollah Sistani, hafazallahu ta'ala alayh. When a marja passes away, the whole community becomes yatim. It becomes an orphan. And sometimes I think that we do injustice to some ulamas, like Sheikh Ibrahim Zakzaki. Maybe he's not mentioned much. Maybe we don't remember him in our duas. If some things they are out of our control, at least we could pray for them. A Nigerian human rights lawyer has called for the immediate and unconditional release of senior Shia cleric and leader of the Islamic movement of Nigeria, Sheikh Ibrahim al-Zakzaki. Zakzaki and his wife have been in detention since December last year. The clergyman is said to have been charged with criminal conspiracy and inciting public disturbance. This is his crime. Now his lawyer says that even though our clients have not been told that they breached any law, they have been denied access to their lawyers, personal physicians, and family members for over 3 months. Our clients were only, meaning Sheikh Ibrahim Zakzaki and his wife, our clients were only permitted to meet with us last Friday after several requests made by us had been turned down without any legal basis. Zakzaki had lost his left eye due to the brutal attacks during his arrest, because they raided his house, they attacked his house. He lost his eye, his left eye, and now the doctors are battling to cure his right eye. We pray for all the ulamas, for their safety, for the safety and protection for all the Muslimin and Mu'minin and Mu'minat around the world. Allahumma ghfir lil Mu'minina wal Mu'minat wal Muslimina wal Muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat tabi' baynana wa baynahum bil khairat innaka mujibu da'awat إنك على كل شيء قدير وآخر الدعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.